All right, man. Go ahead and videotape me. I'm going to walk through the steps.
Just come over here, buddy.
Okay.
Come over here. Like right there, I'm gonna walk through from here, okay?
Okay.
You got it? Yes,
sir.
Alright. So first off, I always start from the connector links here.
Mm-hmm.
The three rings, because I know that it's not twisted. Okay. Okay. You got it, buddy?
Yeah.
So it looks. Alright, cool. Alright, so I'm gonna start from here because I know it's not twisted, so this is where I'll make sure my rods are not twisted. I'm gonna walk it up and I'm gonna break it up into three groups: the front, rear, and control lines. And I'm gonna walk it up. Now I just did I checked all the lines. So I did a major repair. Right now I'm just gonna even it out, make sure my grommets are even, and it tells me that my pack tray is even. Okay.
Okay.
So a lot of guys will throw the slider over the their backs, so I don't do that. I'll use a slider as kind of my quartering my bag. Find my stabilizers and just kind of set it right away. The first thing I'm going to do is I want to make sure this slider is actually fully expanded back out. Okay. This one's actually, so you can tell right here, it's actually supposed to go inside. There you go, just like that. So whoever packed this last did not fully expand the slider. Okay, I'm coming here, grommets even. I always start in the middle. This is my rear, this is my bottom, this is my front right here. So I always start in the middle. I'm gonna put my hands all the way down right here. Come in, and then as I'm doing it, I'm going like this, and I'm gonna expand the slide on the way up, just like that. Okay, up, just like that. Now, back up a little, buddy.
Yes.
Okay. So from here, again, continuously checking, making sure your grommets stay even. Because if they're not, that means your bag is twisted and your lines are not even here. So, I'm going to take my hand, like a karate chop, I'm going to come down where my slider was at. Just like this, and I'm going to come back up, bring it back up. You see my hand right here? Coming all the way down. And now my hand's over here. And I'm going to come up, and I'm basically folding my canopy material out of my lines, which should be in the middle. So folding all my canopy all the way up to my stabilizers. So let me fold my stabilizers. And so I'm doing this all the way up. Then from here, so I got my one stabilizer. I got half of my slider quartered right now. I'm gonna hold this together. You always wanna keep your lines in the middle. The reason we're doing all this, keep your lines in the middle and all the material outside of your lines. So I'm gonna hold my grommets, I'm gonna hold my lines. I'm gonna follow the stabilizer I just created. You can see the slider stops right here. I'm gonna come out and I'm gonna get the next one. Slider number one, stabilizer number one, number two, and the number three is up in the front. I'm gonna open that up here. And then from here, we're just gonna dress it up. We're gonna come down. We're gonna get this tail with the nose. The nose in the front of you. Coming down, keeping all the lines down in the center. Okay. And that's all we're doing here. We're exposing all your lines, keeping them centered. Make sure all the material is out. That's it. Good there. We'll do the same thing here. We'll come down, up. When you come in here, just make sure your hands are under these lines, not over. So like right here, I'm going between these lines. I don't want that. I want to go make sure a slider stays on the palm. I'm going to go all the way down. And then I'm going to bring all this material up to over there. Come up, bam. Now I'm gonna find this slider, come down to the next slider, you know, stabilizer, and then we're gonna come up, just like that, number two. And then I'm gonna come in here, and I'm gonna get them all out. Bam. Just gonna expose this real quick. All right, then from here, I'm just gonna keep that just nicely quartered, come up. And now I'm gonna do the same thing to the front side. I'm gonna find my middle slider, my stabilizer. I'm gonna walk to the front, to the third stabilizer. Bam. And then from here, I'm gonna get my nose and I'm gonna count out my nose. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. So there's nine. Now, A lot of guys just put this right between their legs, which is fine. What I do now, is that I know we had 9, so I'm just gonna count out the 4. 1, or 3. 2, 3. I'm gonna count the next 3 out here. So, starting from here, 1, 2, 3, 4. So it's gonna be 4 on each side and then 1 in the middle. So leave the center one here. As you can see right now, I got it nicely dressed up. I leave it just like that. I'm gonna walk to the front here. Make sure you got 3 stabilizers on each side. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. And then you wanna make sure your grommets still are even. You wanna make sure your slider is still quartered, quartered, quartered. And then up here, I'm gonna bring this out just a little more, quarter just some more. Use the stomach to flatten it. So I want quarter, quarter, and quarter. Okay, this makes it nice and neat, just like that. Bam. All right. So with that, we're gonna take the stabilizers here, and we're just gonna nicely drop them forward. Some guys cross them. I'm just gonna drop them so that they. All I'm doing is that right here. Bam. But they're gonna fold on me. Just something like that. Okay. With my left hand, or actually right now I just got the tail, the center. There should be a control panel. And all I did is I called the last one all the way up. Control panel. Sometimes they mark it with something. Here's a red tab. There'll be some kind of tab here. My main cue is they always put the control panel to the center. Okay. Looking down, I'm making sure there's no lines crossing and all the material is out of my lines. I'm gonna bring this up. Now, one of my techniques for helping to secure all this in your canopy, it's one, ensuring that your grommets are nicely tight and even. We're gonna take the center point and we're gonna come up about 2 inches, so probably about right here. And this is how far we wanna come up when we start wrapping it, okay? So I'm gonna come up 2 inches. All I'm doing right now is holding it. I'm not wrapping it yet. I'm gonna start it now. So using my right leg, since it's on the right side, and then my left leg is on the left side of those nose, I'm gonna get this tail and I'm gonna wrap it around, pushing my right leg up. That's 1. Now I'm gonna switch, and I'm gonna do my left leg. Same thing. I'm pressing right in here, and I'm going forward with it as I come down with my tail. Okay, now that I've wrapped my, I'm gonna switch my hands over to my left hand, because I'm right hand dominant. I am going to line up my seams, so I'm still 2 inches above my grommets here, and I'm going to line up my seam, this guy right here. I'm going to line them up, just like that. I'm going to pull down. As I line them up, run my finger through, I'm going to line all the way down. So as I line it up, and I like this one, the smaller the better, because you can actually have more control. And the bigger, same thing, just put your hand up, come as far as you can with your hand. And then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna extend my fingers and I'm gonna do a big flat fold, just like that. I'm not gonna get it and roll it. I never like rolling canopy because it's not good control. So I'm gonna pinch, pull my bindings together, and I'm gonna do 1, 2, sometimes 3 is enough. You see the tight cocoon?
Looks like a big water droplet.
Yeah. All right, so with that, I'm gonna pull down and I'm not gonna swing it out. Everybody throws a canopy. I never do that. I'm just gonna come straight to the ground. I'm gonna come straight to the ground. My right hand's gonna hit the ground. After it hits the ground, I'm gonna go straight up towards my D-bag rope ahead of me. I'm going like this. My left hand still has control 2 inches of that material above the grommet. I'm gonna come down. Hey, buddy, come over to my left. Okay, so as I'm pulling away, the one thing you'll see is right here, because I was 2 inches above and it came down, it actually kind of locks over your grommets as I pull. That's a good thing. Now what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna put my knee on here as I let go of the top. Put my knee here. Mm-hmm. So now, You wanna come over here, buddy?
And all I'm doing is I'm out. I come all the way up and then I release. Okay. Now come over here, big man. Okay. So go ahead and stand up here and look downwards. My left shoulder, look right here. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is, you see this radio seam? I want it to line up center. First off, it's gonna move a little bit. Then I'm gonna get it from here, my knees on here, preventing this material from shooting up on me. And now I'm gonna come up. I don't do this, all you gotta do is press it. You have to put your body on to get some of the air out, but this canopy is actually a good one. It's really small and it's easy to work with. All right, so a lot of guys won't work with that. At the end, they will start rolling it and stuff like that. What I'm gonna do is, I'm gonna manipulate this canopy for canopy control. I'm gonna take this here, and I'm gonna form a diamond. You can kind of see half the diamond here. If you can picture, when you put this into the bag, you don't want any of this material getting caught up in any of this. That's why we cock it, and that's why we make sure it's cocked before we put it in the bag, which I'm gonna show you that in a little bit. So what I wanna do is, from here down to the widest area, so probably about right here. The reason I picked the widest area is because I want to come over as far as I can to here when I fold it under. So if I do it from down here, I'm gonna have a little bit of work with. Think about it, the fold's gonna come to about right here. So all this, I want over there. This is what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna get here, and I'm just gonna go up like that. That was it. Just came up, right there. Okay. Then what I'm gonna do is, I'm gonna take this here and come at an angle. I'm gonna put my hand here just like this. Back up a little bit, buddy. You're too close. No, stand up and come downwards on it. Can you see it, buddy?
Yes, sir.
Cool. All right. So you can kind of see, there's a smaller canopy, so I don't have a lot, it's not as big. So the bigger the better, because it's easier to wrap on the canopy on this part. But it is good control here. It's really simple, really quick. You got a triangle. I'm gonna use this fold to come over here to secure this as well. Now I'm gonna switch. Now I'm putting my right leg here. You can come over here, you can put your leg on if you have to. Same thing here, I'm gonna come up. One, find the center right here, come down. Has to come under here, I'm sorry, flip it like that. Never grab the material and start rolling and rubbing, because what you do is, you cause bulk and the canopy is going to want to come back out on you. So that's at the perfect diamond, kind of an offset here. Normally I want them as even as I can. Awesome. I'm gonna take this part here, I'm gonna fold it over here. I'm gonna do right, then I'm gonna do left, and I'm gonna lap them. The reason I go right then left is because I'm right-handed, I wanna grab it this way. You might wanna switch it left then right if you're left-handed. So what I'm gonna do now, first off, I'm gonna kinda wanna prep the D-bag a little bit. We're still gonna cock this before we put it in, so y'all know. And you can tell it's not cocked, because you shouldn't see all this. When it's cocked, it will look like this, and all this white will be shot up in there. Okay, so we'll get to that. So what I wanna do now is, I wanna find the width of the D bag, which is a very small one. It's right here, and it's right here. So basically, this part here is gonna get folded, and this part here is gonna get folded. So again, I always do right then left, because I'm right-handed. So you can put your hand underneath like this, right here, and you can fold it under. Or you can come here and put your elbow down. You try to put your knee wherever you want the line, and then you hold it here, and you can kind of see a form of line there. You do that as well. Okay, you can kind of see how it's almost the width of the D-bag there. We're gonna switch now. Same thing, I can put my elbow here, control that. Find the line I want here. Same thing with my knee, find where you want it to bend.
Okay.
Okay, we're still gonna cock that, okay? But we haven't gotten there yet. We're gonna do... Now, according to a lot of instructions, you normally will cock that before you even get started. Me, I always do it after this because I just know I'm gonna do it again, so. Come over here. Now get in front of me, big man. Okay, so from here, you can tell my grommets are still together. I still got line separation, which is a good thing. And I got my canopy still secured. You don't ever really want your grommets exposed or your lines exposed. And you start messing around with tanglements and things like that. So what I'm gonna do is put my hand underneath like this, and I'm gonna bring it up just like this, bringing this bag from about this width to about this width, lining it up. Coming here, I'll put my hand here to hold it down. Use a pack tray if you can, or you can bring it in just like this. Either or. Right now, the only reason I'm bringing this down is because the pack tray over there, I kind of went over my weight ball, so. But normally I like to use the weight of the bag, but either way, you just gotta kinda figure it out. So you can see right now, the fold looks pretty good. We're gonna place it down in the center. Just like that. I'm gonna come on here, I'm gonna put my right leg on here. Now the next thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna bring this on top. Everybody will grab this and come up to their chest. Okay, I don't do that. What I do is I'll hold it here, keeping my left hand on it, keep my right hand here, and I secure any material or anything that needs to be inside, and I come up keeping it down. Any excess that didn't get properly folded, you can tuck in now, because as you have this bend here and this fold and this pressed down, you can tuck any excess material inside here if you need to, okay? I always like to see this in the middle, because it knows that everything's controlled, it hasn't, there wasn't a lot of play. I'm gonna get my right hand, I'm gonna come where my knees at, and I'm gonna secure it. Now come over here, man. And I'm just doing this right here, okay? Then what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna bring this on top. To bring it on top, I'm gonna squish down, okay? All right. Do you wanna stand up? Okay, so now you gotta cock that. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put my right leg on here. Okay, my right leg's on here. I'm gonna come in here and I'm gonna start cocking this. Make sure it's not twisted. I'm gonna take this guy right here. I'm gonna step on it. I'm gonna walk it up. So as I walk it up, I'm gonna milk out the lines. But here it should be blue. See a little blue right there? That's what we're looking for, okay? Now, when you put it into the container, you gotta keep being mindful. All the bridles are different, so some have a protective, this one does not. That means this material can get caught up in that line that we just pulled, and when it opens, it can get stuck, okay? So when you put this in there, don't pull on the bag too much because you're gonna basically pull that right back out. So now what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna take these doggies here. I'm gonna slide over to my left. I'm not gonna really insert it into the bag a whole lot. I'm just gonna leave it just like that. I'm gonna use my left knee to step on that dog ear that I just had there, okay? I really don't care about all this yet. I'm gonna actually shove this part of the bag first. If you keep this guy toward the middle and not up here, it won't pull away from the blue that we just saw on that bridle, okay? So if it's way up here, you're pulling away from it. Your goal is to keep it center in the middle right here. This is one of the issues I saw with this parachute when I pulled it out of the pack tray, is I didn't see blue right away. It's because this guy was getting pulled up here. And then I'm gonna shove it in the bag. Use the dog ears, control it. I made this bag nice and tight. Awesome. All right. It's actually a really cool looking bag. Every time you pack, I pack parachutes, I always see different ones. Okay. Now that it's in the pack tray, you can kind of walk around and show it, buddy. What I like to see, some of the things I like to see is, you have your two distinct groups right here, your center, and you do want this as controlled as possible, as secure. nice and neat. I still got my two distinct line groups, which always makes me feel comfortable knowing there's not gonna be twists or tanglements or bag locks. There's not any excess coming out. I knew that when I put it in, the grommet stayed here in the middle. It didn't pull up here, okay? So now I'm gonna do one more recock. So I'm actually coming here. I'm gonna step on it, step in the bag, and I'm gonna just make sure I cocked it really good. Boom, blue. We're ready to go. Now I'm gonna close the bag. I always do it from this way, because I like to bring it up like that without pulling any tension on my lines. I'm just gonna dress it up just a tad as I need to. This is how I like to look at it every time. Okay, this makes me look, feel like it's not gonna lock on me or have any issues. Okay, as I close the bag, I normally the first one or two bite or stoves, I normally will put the rubber band in first, then I bring the bite in. But all the other ones, you're gonna see me hold one side of the bite and bring it. So I changed my routine on these compared to these. This your music buddy?
Yeah.
Nice. Okay, so another thing I don't do, I don't just grab lines because I like to keep the two distinct line groups that came out like this. And sometimes I like the four distinct line groups where it's like two and two. So with this being said, I use like a shotgun or a finger, less distraction on my lines. What I'm looking for is this right here. I want to continuously see that type of line group or separation. I'm pinching my fingers together, bringing it in.
You guys are boss.
Now, stop, buddy. So, the rubber band here, these are actually kind of loose for this bag. So, you can do it twice, but when you do that, just make sure, and I'll show you real quick. So, when you do it, make sure that the rubber bands are actually tight lined together. They're not separate, because then you have material getting between the rubber bands and you don't want that, okay? And what you want to keep trying to look for is the two groups. And this one I didn't do perfect on it because I had to rechange it. Come in here, put it through. Normally it's always left, right, but just check the manual. This one here. Can you move that back for me? Oh, here, I got it. So now I can hold it here, bring this in here. So you don't want that right there. A couple things I don't like about this D-bag is I don't like that they have allow you to have big bites. I like it smaller bites, tighter. I think 1 inches are safer. A lot of sport rigs always allow for that. I don't like that. They also like to have a lot of excess at the end. I don't like that either. Okay. Make sure it's not wide. Make sure these don't go wider than this right here. Okay. Come over here. We're gonna prep this real quick. So, gotta get a pull-up cord. I'll be right back. Alright, so what we're going to do is control your lines in the center. Have tension on your risers as you come up. I'm going to get up, buddy. Make sure your riser gets... Right now, I don't care about the twist yet. We're going to walk from here down and undo the twist. What I care about is as you come over here, you can see this. Come over here, buddy. Look at my lines inside here. So I want to just make sure that my lines are not all everywhere. Not to play with them too much. You're just going to drop it in. Leave it alone right now. Over here. Now come back over here, buddy. Okay, starting from the right, only because it's a habit. I start from my three rings. I know it's not twisted. I'm going to come down. I'm gonna untwist any of my risers. Look at that right there. Could not stow that. Those are too short. Gotta get longer ones. Okay, push down. And then what I'm gonna do here. I'm gonna take this access, I'm gonna line it up. This first. Down. I still see blue, which is a good thing. Center. Sorry, get some twist out here. Down. Boom, boom, nice and neat. Also look at lower these locking loop sides. So you can see the grommets are separate. We're gonna have to do this locking loop again. And what you want is to not be able to see that grommet, just so I would know that it's tighter, okay? This is good, it's nice and tight, but I want it tighter. Come in here, I'll do the, now we're gonna do our pilot shoot. Take out all the bridle slack. Be careful not to pull too much because we don't want it to pull on the blue. Okay, what we're gonna do, I'm gonna take this guy here, the ball inside, I'm gonna hold it, I'm gonna go the opposite direction. over here, just like that. So what that does is when you pull it, you shouldn't have any slack in it, so just like that. Okay, we're gonna bring this guy right back over here. Again, so when I pull it, it doesn't bunch up any of my material, okay? Then I'm gonna flip it so I can have control of this guy here. One, we do half and half. Three or four of these, so about two should work. Then we're gonna do one on top. We walk up to the container. Get this twist out. Bam. Okay. You gotta make sure the ball is right there. And you wanna go smaller than loose at the end. So you want it tighter so you can pull out. And this left over here is gonna lap over, just like that. So if I pull this, it's not gonna bunch up my material, vice versa. And then I'm gonna basically just come straight in. Okay, then I'm just gonna rub it, the material, make sure it's nice and flat. Some have a tab that will go right into here, be like a double tab, this one doesn't. What I do want is that it doesn't protrude too far out, but it's enough that when I put my hand like this, basically hits my hand. This here, I don't want it exposed. So what I'm gonna do, is I'm gonna trace it in from here, just like that. Come in here and secure it inside, just like that, okay? I don't want it exposed, gonna come back in. Close it up. Nothing exposed. Ball, easy to grab. Get that over. We're both miss these flaps. Every shoe's different, at least that one. Okay, cool. Good to go. Blue still, smiley face, posture's good, factory's good. All right, good to go. Get your off, buddy.
It is packed.